Hello dear students, time series we are discussing. Time series first two methods are over. Now coming to the third method, that is moving average method. This is very easy and easy to score. When I was in BCom, this problem has come in the final exam. I have scored full marks, quite easy, just to focus 5 minutes. Moving average means for every year we'll be taking averages by moving year by year. So confused? Nothing to worry. We'll enter into the problem so that you'll have more clarity. So here it is given, calculate 5-year moving average. 5-year moving average for the following data. What is the data given? Year and production. Only this is the data given to us. Year and production is given. What they are saying, calculate 5-year moving average. 5-year moving average. It can be anything like 3-year moving average, 4-year moving average, 2-year moving average. It can be any number. Now, right now in this problem, they are asking us to calculate 5-year moving average. Data is so many years are there. And production in 1000 units, it's like this. We have to calculate 5-year moving average. For that, what we have to do is first total of 5 years, like that will total. So this is what I have done, 5-year moving total. 5-year moving total, then after that 5-year moving average. So 5-year moving total, first 5 years, 14, 15, 14, 17, 22, 28, 26. If we total first 5 years, we'll be getting 107. 107 we are getting. 107 we are writing in the middle, exactly opposite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Middle one is this one. This is middle one. Opposite to that, we are writing 107. Are you getting it? Next, after that, next year, we are going to take these 5 years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Leaving 1 year and coming to the second year onwards. Second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, sixth year. So these five, if you total up, we are getting 111. Triple one will write opposite to the 28 because this is middle, opposite. In the same way, next, we'll take next 5 years, this. If you total up these five, we'll be getting 114. So this is also opposite in the middle. Like first, we have done 5-yearly moving total. Once if you do the 5-year moving total, then we'll go for average. 5-year average. Another column opened and written 5-yearly moving averages. So if you see first year, second year, there is no data. Because when we have calculated first to 5, the first data, it comes 107 opposite to the middle one. In the same way, last 2 also, there is no data at all. So whatever data we got it, whatever average, 5-year average we got it, that we are going to total, whatever we got, that we are going to make it average. For average, 107 we got here. 107 by 5. 5-year average means 107 by divided by 5. So you will get 21.4. In the same way, 111 divided by 5, 22.2. Then 114 divided by 5. 22.8. Like you got average. Shall I explain you once again? Simple problem is given to you this much only. They'll ask you 3 years average, moving average, 5 years average. Whatever they say, that you have to calculate. 5 years they said. So first 5 years total I have done. Average is 107 divided by 5. You'll get this one. Second one is by leaving 1. First 5. Like this you are totaling everything. So that is total of 5 years moving data. Then average we have done. Simple, that's it. So that you will come to know exactly. So how much is the average for the last 5 years? For the last 5 years, average is going like this. Simple thing, nothing to worry. And if you get in the exam, don't leave this in choice. You have to attempt because you will get full marks. There is no complication. No need to use this one also. Simple one. And in the coming classes, two more methods are weighted average and least square, which is very much important for the examination point of view. And also in real use, least square method, we can use it wonderfully. So these two methods I'll be focusing. So please watch the description box. There are different subjects, different topics. Use it and do share this videos with your friends or juniors or seniors. It may be useful for someone. So thank you very much for spending your valuable time to learn the subject. Wish you good luck. Take care.